The 10% to 1% salary increases that the government has offered to pay public servants are not sitting well with the People's Progressive Party Civic. Its leader, Clement Rohe, sat before media operatives this morning to complain.
The question that is to be asked is whether government's final offer is reflective of the 20% increase that was promised to public servants in the APNU AFC 2015 manifesto.
When the government announced its final offer, the Ghana Public Service Union said that it will have to have a general meeting to discuss the offer before a decision is made to accept or decline the proposed raise. Rohe is, however, accusing the union of not having the best interest of public servants at heart.
The GPSU must come clean, and in the interest of transparency and accountability, explain to its members the true state of affairs in respect to the outcome of the negotiations and how the final offer was arrived at.
The former Home Affairs Minister expressed confidence that the GPSU will not put up a fight to get a bigger raise for the people it represents.
Knowing the track record of the Ghana Public Service Union, it will most likely go along with the government's final offer on the basis of some lame excuse, and this will no doubt be tantamount to another betrayal.
The proposed 10% is definitely an upgrade from the PUP's regular proposal of 5%. So what exactly is the opposition's concern? As this, Rohe attempted to show how his party did more for public servants while in office.
In other words, there were a whole set of other concessions that were granted to workers in order to cushion whatever plus every year they would get this big bonus increase. So I think it was a much better deal that they got under the PPP.
Many would recall that the one and only time the PPP's salary increase for public servants went beyond a 5% was leading up to the 2011 general elections, which did not exactly work as planned, because that was the year the party was reduced to a minority government. Rihanna Ahmad, Safe TV 2 Headline News.